Hey, fellow space enthusiasts! If you're as excited about SpaceX and space exploration as I am, hit that subscribe button below. Stay in the loop with the latest SpaceX news, launches, and missions. Don't miss out. Subscribe now and join our SpaceX community today. SpaceX recently conducted a significant test of its Starship engines under frigid lunar-like conditions, a crucial step towards making the dream of human moon landings a reality within the next few years. The private space exploration company, SpaceX, is on a mission to transport the Artemis 3 crew to the moon's surface using its state-of-the-art Starship spacecraft, with a target date of 2025 or 2026. NASA officials confirmed the successful completion of a cold engine ignition test back in August, which was a significant milestone in proving the readiness of SpaceX's Raptor engine. This test aimed to demonstrate that the Raptor engine could be reignited in the vacuum of space after departing Earth, a vital capability for safely delivering astronauts to the lunar surface. In a captivating video shared on SpaceX's official social media platform X, formerly known as Twitter, viewers were treated to a spectacle of the Raptor engine firing in the extreme cold at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center in Alabama, lasting for approximately 3 seconds. Starship represents the future of deep space exploration according to SpaceX's ambitious plans. However, it's important to note that Starship has yet to make its maiden voyage into space. Earlier this year, SpaceX attempted its first launch of a fully stacked Starship, a rocket of unprecedented size and power. Unfortunately, this maiden flight was marred by significant issues, resulting in a loss of control, a remote detonation, and debris scattered across the vicinity. In the wake of these challenges, the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, oversaw an exhaustive investigation into the launch mishap. On September 8th, the FAA concluded its investigation and identified 63 corrective actions for SpaceX, based in Hawthorne, California, to address. SpaceX's founder and CEO, Elon Musk, swiftly announced that the company had completed 57 of these corrections, leaving only a few adjustments required for future missions. Elon Musk's optimism shines through as he hints at the possibility of Starship making another ascent into the skies in the near future. Furthermore, the FAA appears to be supportive of SpaceX's endeavors, with indications that a new Starship launch attempt could be granted a license as early as October. Simultaneously, both SpaceX and the FAA are actively working to dismiss a lawsuit filed by environmental groups in the aftermath of the Starship's tumultuous April launch. The successful Raptor engine test has bolstered NASA's confidence in SpaceX's ability to fulfill its commitments for the Artemis 3 mission. NASA officials expressed their satisfaction, noting that these tests offer early validation of the systems necessary for lunar missions, further boosting the agency's trust in the readiness of the U.S. space industry for this historic endeavor. It's worth highlighting that SpaceX achieved a significant milestone with the Raptor engine back in November 2021. During that test, the engine fired continuously for an impressive 281 seconds, equivalent to 4.5 minutes, meeting the duration requirement for the long descent to the moon's surface. Additionally, Raptor demonstrated the capability to adjust its power level during testing to align with NASA's stringent requirements, showcasing its versatility and reliability. While SpaceX makes steady progress with its engine tests, NASA Associate Administrator Jim Free cautioned in August that NASA remains prepared to launch Artemis 3, even if Starship isn't fully ready for a moon landing by 2025 or 2026, the current target date. This stance follows Free's earlier expressions of concern about Starship's ability to meet the 2025 launch deadline. During an August 8th press conference held at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, Free proposed the possibility of omitting the moon landing from Artemis 3 if necessary, and pursuing an alternative mission with a crew. In such a scenario, Starship could be reserved for a future mission, like Artemis 4, marking the first human lunar landing since Apollo 17 in 1972. NASA's criteria for authorizing a crewed lunar landing with Starship include the successful completion of multiple launches, among other milestones. The agency remains vigilant and will closely monitor the performance of the Raptor engines during Starship's second launch attempt, as mentioned in NASA's recent blog post. Artemis 3 represents the third installment in NASA's ambitious Artemis program, a collaborative effort involving international partners working under the guidelines of the Artemis Accords. These accords serve as a framework for lunar exploration commitments and peaceful space exploration norms, though not all signatories have committed to direct involvement in Artemis missions. The Artemis program commenced with Artemis 1, where an uncrewed NASA Orion spacecraft successfully orbited the moon in late 2022. Artemis 2 is up next, scheduled to send three NASA astronauts and a Canadian counterpart on a lunar orbit mission, expected to take place no earlier than November 2024, utilizing NASA's Space Launch System, SLS rocket, and Orion spacecraft. It's important to note that SpaceX is not the exclusive contractor responsible for transporting humans on NASA's lunar missions. In May 2023, a consortium led by Blue Origin also secured eligibility to bid for missions after Artemis 4, following a competitive selection process. Initially, SpaceX was chosen as the sole contractor eligible for Artemis 3 and Artemis 4 under NASA's Human Landing System, HLS, award in April 2021. This decision came as a surprise to competitors who anticipated NASA would select at least two landing systems, a standard practice for risk mitigation. Subsequently, the two other consortia, led by Blue Origin and Dynetics, respectively, raised objections and filed protests with the Government Accountability Office, GAO. Blue Origin even initiated a lawsuit in response to the decision. Amid these legal proceedings, the SpaceX contract was temporarily delayed. Eventually, NASA was given the green light to proceed with SpaceX's contract. In September 2021, the Senate Appropriations Committee directed NASA to choose a second company to develop a crewed Artemis lander. This directive initiated a new HLS bidding process that ultimately awarded Blue Origin the contract. Senate officials emphasized that NASA's HLS program was not underfunded, refuting the agency's previous assertion that underfunding was the rationale behind selecting only SpaceX. NASA's budget for that fiscal year, totaling $24.83 billion, exceeded the agency's request by a slight margin, with a substantial portion allocated to the HLS program.